Today, I'm going to go over briefly one of my favorite Obsidian plugins, which is the Waypoint plugin by this person, Idrees Hassan, perhaps is how it's pronounced. And just today, we got a brand new version of it, and that's why I'm going to talk about it. It's one that I found myself, you know, a handful of times recommending to people on the Obsidian subreddit and the Obsidian forums, because it's a very unique plugin for a couple things that I'll go over. So it's called Waypoints, and what it does is it basically makes a it works within folder notes, so it's not going to work in just any note. It's specifically designed for folder notes, which are notes that are the same name as the folder they're in. They kind of function as a turning that folder into a note itself, kind of with subnotes, is a way to think about it. You know, if you read comments or, you know, just see people talking about MOCs and stuff like that, or a table of contents notes or index notes, these are all something that could most likely benefit from this plugin. So what does it do exactly? It's pretty simple. You put a little tiny thing in your folder note, which is 2% signs, and then the word waypoint, and then 2% signs. And the plugin watches for notes that have that, and it will place a real-time markdown version of all the notes in that same directory, as well as all the notes in subdirectories. So this is something you could do with data view, for example. The main difference is that this is an actual markdown, whereas data view would be, you know, in a code block and wouldn't actually create any links between those notes inherently, which I think is a big plus for Waypoint in most cases. But if you don't want that, then obviously data view or some other solution would be better for you. So as you can see, you get a little demonstration there. Features: automatically generate table of contents. Waypoints are created whenever you type the magic word. And yeah, that's the default. You can change on the settings to whatever word you want, basically. Within a folder note, instant updates whenever files or folders are created, renamed, moved, or deleted. And it is instant. It's super quick. Folders can now appear on the graph view. So another difference, besides just making those actual links and connections between the notes in those folders, is that they will also have that connection represented on the graph view, which again, data view and other more dynamic Cody stuff like that won't do in most cases. And so landmarks is the new feature. So I'm going to see if I can get those to work, and we'll play around with it and see how interesting it is. So this is a sandbox vault. It's got just like Obsidian help files basically in it. We're going to mess around with that. It's got Waypoint installed, and then you also need a folder note plugin, because the folder note functionality isn't native to Obsidian. There's a handful of folder note plugins. The one that I use in my main vault is called Folder Notes, and it is by Lost Paul. This is the one that I like. It's pretty simple. If we look right here at the sidebar, we're going to have just a few folders, you can see. If we click on the folder name, all that happens is that they expand and collapse. If we right-click it, we go Folder Note Commands is going to be an option now because of that Folder Note plugin. And you can see we've got a couple of different things. We can create a canvas folder note if you want. Which won't work with Waypoint, but might be something that you want, at least in a couple instances, maybe not all the time, but the option's there to give you a canvas file inside that folder. It'll have the same name, and then it'll function as a folder note. We're going to create markdown folder note, and as you can see up here, now we've got Adventurer, which is the folder name, and then we've got the note name, which is Adventurer, and then if we click on let's go to one of the other notes, and you can see now we've got an underline for Adventurer, which we don't have for formatting, we don't have for guides. So obviously something's different, right? So what's different? Well, because of the folder note, if we click on Adventurer, what happens by default is it opens up that note. Instead of expanding the folder on the sidebar, it opens up the note. Now, if we click the arrow, boom, right? You haven't lost functionality, you've gained some. For the Waypoint plugin, all you do, percent percent, waypoint, %%, boom, there you go. We automatically have a bullet list that has all of the inside notes here from plain text note taking, standard note taking, Let's click on them there, boom. Let's turn on backlinks. Where is that? Backlinks and document right up here. And then if we go down here, we're automatically going to have, as you can see, Adventurer, because it's got an actual genuine link there. And then of course, when you're in the reading mode, you know, you don't get the little comment waypoint and a begin waypoint stuff. You've got just the list there. And let's right click. Let's go new note. Okay, we got an untitled note there. Let's go back to the thing. Oh, boom. Untitled note right there. Automatically, instantaneously. You know what? Let's move the adventurer folder. Let's move that into the formatting folder. And then let's make some more formatting folders here. Let's say new folder, my favorite formats. And let's make another one. And we'll say, I hate these formats. And you know what? I really like block quotes. I like callouts. Hate code blocks. Oh, get them away. Hate diagrams. Hate embeds. I like emphasis. I like footnotes. Now, to go back up here to Adventurer, right? Boom, click out, go back up here. That's all the same because that's only going to what's in the Adventurer folder. If we go formatting, let's right click. Let's go folder note commands and create a markdown folder. And let's make another waypoint. What's going to happen? That took a couple seconds that time, going through a bit. Now, we've got Adventurer right up here, which is kind of bold. And then down here, we've got bold, and then we've got the list of what's in those folders. So it's a little tree there. So it doesn't do that for Adventurer, though. So by default, that's how it's going to behave. If it comes across a folder note that has another waypoint in it, it's going to stop there. So let's make a folder note. And I hate these formats. So now we have that there, but it also still lists the ones underneath there. Let's add the waypoints back up to formatting and same thing. See? So by default, it's not going to, the notes, the folder notes that have waypoints are going to prevent it from going down and propagating in the higher one. So this is going to look just like the other ones, except it's bold. So your notes are folder. And then if you click that, you've got the navigation there. What if we wanted this to be a clickable link to a folder note and still have this though and keep the waypoint functionality? That's what this landmark one does. So, and again, you can change it, but by default, it's landmark in the enclosed percentage signs. Let's go up here. Let's just delete all that and let's go landmark. And it's going to do the same thing. The only difference is if we go back up to formatting now, I hate these formats, and we've got code block, diagram, embeds listed there. So why wouldn't you want it to just give you a full tree of the directories and notes underneath there? Maybe you do. Maybe you do. That's cool. But maybe you want a little bit more control, and that's where this new notation comes in. So you can kind of fine-tune how you want it to work. And maybe you just use landmarks for everything so that everything, no matter what note you're in, you've always got that, you know, however deep it goes in there. So for example, like, let's make this a folder note. Let's put a landmark in there. Let's go back up to formatting. You can see now we've got that broken out too, broken out there. Let's click and drag. So, and now you can see we've got, I hate these formats, all these, and then we've got the other folder with the folder note that has the landmark note in there. Boom. And if we click my favorite formats, boom, we've got that right there. Let's go back up to Adventurer. Let's make that a landmark too. All right, nothing seems to really change here. Let's put this in. There we go. My favorite formats, Adventurer right at top because it's first alphabetically, then block out, call out, emphasis, footnote, boom. Now if we go back in here, let's go back and do the waypoint, the regular thing. Oh, on it, boom. Formatting, and then again, it's gonna collapse it. So Waypoints and landmarks are two little notations you can use in your folder notes to give you automatic directory listings of the subfolders and subnotes that belong within that that main group. Waypoints are going to stop the tree if they hit other waypoints, but not if they hit other landmarks. The terminology is a little, you know, a little unusual, right? But it's pretty, it is pretty straightforward once you figure it out. This is something that I have just in like my default templates that I use for folder notes. I find it incredibly useful. If you're someone that doesn't use folders a lot, you won't find it as useful. And definitely check out the Waypoint plugin. And then, tell me what you like. If you have any questions about it, ask me. I'm sometimes slow to respond, but if I see one that I can help out with, find an answer, I do. So there you go. Have a good night.